Guys, it's Annette, and it's time to share with you what books I got from England at the start of June. It's currently thundering outside, so if you can hear that on the video, well, it's the soundtrack for this film. The majority of the books are pretty well-known YA releases, so I'm not gonna go into too much detail what they're about because you've probably heard it a thousand times already. But I have some other books as well to show you, so let us get started. First book I have here is A Court of Mist and Fury by Sarah J. Maas, the sequel for A Court of Thorns and Roses. I already read this and I freaking loved it. I'm gonna talk about it more in my July wrap-up, but probably one of my favorite books ever. Rhysand is so amazing, amazing. The next book I bought from England, I was kind of debating whether to get it or not because all the other books by this author I have in the US hardcovers. But then I was so impatient that I ended up getting this at the start of June. I just couldn't resist when I saw it in the shops. So I got this Savage Song by V. Schwab, and I really like the UK cover as well, but I probably will get the hardcover version of this as well. And all I know about this book is that violence is creating monsters, and V. Schwab's writing, you can't go wrong with that. Next up, I got a psychological thriller, and that is Before I Go to Sleep by S.J. Watson. It tells about this woman who's lost all her memories because of an accident that has happened, and she keeps this journal about the previous days, and the journal says not to trust her husband Ben, and that's the premise of this book. I already read this as well. It was enjoyable, but not like mind-blowingly amazing. Next up, I got a short story by Rainbow Rowell, and that is Kindred Spirits. This was the World Book Day book of 2016. It's about this girl who decides to go and queue for the premiere tickets for the new Star Wars film outside the cinema. And even though I'm not a Star Wars fan, I could really relate to the queue parties because I've done that for Lord of the Rings and Harry Potter as well. And I just thought it was really cute. I got The Raven King by Maggie Stiefwater. This is the last book in the Raven Cycle series. The cover is absolutely amazing, really beautiful. I've read the first book in this series and I really enjoyed it. The writing is just beautiful and I can't wait to finish this series. I also got The Rest of Us Just Live Here by Patrick Ness. All I know about this book is that it's about people who are not the chosen ones or the heroes of the story. And Patrick Ness, I liked. It's really thundering out there now. I really like the Monster Calls by him, so I'm looking forward to reading this as well. Next up, I got a couple of books in the Lunar Chronicles series. I got Stars Above, which is the short story collection, and I got Winter by Marissa Meyer as well, which is the last book in the Lunar Chronicles series. This is huge. I don't think I've ever had a paperback this massive. I'm a bit scared to read it because I don't think the spine is gonna make it untouched. But I'm still really excited to get to this. I've read Cinder, the first book in the series, and if you don't know, these are retellings of popular fairy tales with cyborgs. Next up, a couple of summer contemporaries. I don't actually know anything about these books, to be honest. I just bought them because of the covers, and the reviews have been generally pretty good. And sometimes when it's good weather in the summer, I feel like reading a cutesy summer contemporary. So the first one I got is The Square Root of Summer by Harriet Reuter Hapgood. Nice sprayed edges with some letters and stuff. My heart is a kaleidoscope, and when we kiss, it makes my world unravel. I don't know anything about this, to be honest. I just bought it because, yeah, summer contemporaries. And the other one I got is Whisper to Me by Nick Lake. I admit this was a cover purchase because purple is one of my favorite colors. And again, I don't really know anything about this. I've seen this around loads in Bookstagram, and generally I think people have actually really liked this book, so hopefully it will be good. Then I got The Sleeping Prince by Melinda Salisbury, which is the sequel for The Sin Eater's Daughter. This is kind of like a high fantasy version of the Shatter Me series. Not really, but there's a girl with a lethal touch as well, and it sounds interesting, and the covers are really nice. Then I got You Know Me Well by Nina LaCour and David Levithan. This is a LGBT story. There's Mark and Kate. Mark is in love with his best friend Ryan, who may or may not love him back. And Kate is running away from a chance of meeting the girl she has loved from afar. And basically Mark and Kate end up meeting one night, I think in New York, and becoming friends. Next up, another book I don't really know much about. I think this came in a subscription box a while ago, so it was around Bookstagram loads. And I got interested because, again, people were saying really good things about this. So hopefully it won't disappoint me. And it's The Serpent King by Jeff Zentner. It's small town dreams, secret love, and a dark past. Sounds good to me, so I bought it. And I also got Night Owls by Jen Bennett. I believe this is a story about a boy and a girl who meet on a night bus in San Francisco, and I guess there's a romance of some sort, and heard good things about this. I think this is called something else in the US. Is it like the anatomical shape of the heart, maybe? But I loved the UK cover, so I got this one. Also got two books from my friend. She was about to get rid of these, and they seemed interesting to me, so I asked if I could have them. They're old library books, and the other one is The Rituals of Dinner. So basically it just goes through the history of table manners and dinner, you know, like everything that goes with dinner. And it sounded interesting to me because I like weird history books like that. So yeah. And the other one I got is Trick and Treat, How Healthy Eating is Making Us Ill. And again, I'm kind of interested in this sort of thing because I have an autoimmune disease, and healthy eating is a big part of like managing the illness. I find these sort of researches interesting because of that. So then I also got The Bricks That Built the Houses by Kate Tempest. I think she's a poet, so the language in this novel is supposed to be really poetic. And it tells about this group of friends who have become kind of disillusioned with their lives and jobs, and they basically pack their car with money and leave. Hopefully you can still hear me talking over that thunder. And this book is basically, I think it goes back in time kind of, and looks what has happened for them to become disillusioned with their lives and what makes them leave London, basically. And oh, the inside, the end papers of the book are really interesting. There's a shark. I'm not sure if that's anything to do with the story, but I guess we'll find out. Another cover purchase for me was What Is Not Yours Is Not Yours by Helen Oyemi. I really love this UK book. It has open-ended spine, which is really interesting. So it opens quite like all the way, basically. I think this is like a short story collection, and what's common with the stories is keys, both literal and metaphorical. And I think there was a common theme of like social and personal justice as well, if I'm not mistaken. But Helen Ojemi, I'm quite interested to read books from her. I have Boy Snowbird as well on my shelves. Still haven't read it, but hopefully soon. Then I also got The Sudden Appearance of Hope, which I saw Regan from Peruse Project Hall a while ago, and I got interested in this book. It's basically, this tells about this girl who no one remembers meeting, and that makes her dangerous, and that's all I know about this book. So I bought Shrill by Lindsay West, Notes from a Loud Woman. These are feminist essays by her, and it says at the back of the book, "Women are told from birth that it's our job to be small, physically small, small in our presence and small in our impact on the world. We're supposed to spend our lives passive, quiet and hungry. With this book, I want to obliterate that expectation." So I just thought it sounded really good. The Goodreads reviews for this book are generally really positive, so hopefully I'll enjoy this. And the last book I got from England is The Women in White by Wilkie Collins. This is a Penguin cloth-bound edition, which I've been eyeing for a while now because it's gorgeous. Okay, the book is huge, so I'm not sure when I get around to reading this because it's a classic and I'm a bit scared of classics. Then I'll go quickly go through the graphic novels I also bought. So I got Deadly Class Volume 3, The Snake Pit, which is one of my favorite graphic novel series. It's really kind of gritty, the art style is quite dark, and it tells about the school for assassins. And I've loved the first two volumes, so hopefully this will be as good. I also got I Hate Fairyland by Scotty Young, the first volume, Madly Ever After. I heard this being described as a mix of Deadpool with Alice in Wonderland, and I was like, yes, that sounds so awesome, I need to have it. And the art style is pretty bright and colorful. And it just looked really good. Once I got back home, I went to this graphic novel store. And what did I see when I walked in? First of all, there was the third volume in Sex Criminal series, Three the Hard Way. It tells about this couple who discover that when they have sex and climax, they basically stop the time and they can rob banks to save their local library. And first of all, the premise is absolutely bonkers, but I love it. I'm not gonna show any photos from inside the graphic novel because with my luck I'm gonna open it to some picture of a huge cock or something. It's really graphic. This is for adults. But it's hilarious. And next to the Sex Criminals, a few days early, before the release date, I saw Saga Volume 6. Oh my god, I love this series so much. It's what got me into graphic novels, and it's so amazing. I love this series so much. Go and check it out. Also, when I got back to Finland, I got a few of the new Little Black Classics, because I love this so much. The first one I got is A Terrible Beauty is Born by V.B. Yeats, The Queen of Spades by Alexander Pushkin. And this one tells about a young card player whose obsession with winning becomes a terrible curse. And I really need to get into the Russian classics because Russian studies was actually my major, and I still haven't read any of the big Russian classics. I don't know how it happened, but I really need to get myself into them and start reading them again. Also, I got The Lifted Veil by George Eliot. This one explores clairvoyance, fate and the possibility of life after death. And the last one I got is My Life Stood a Loaded Gun by Emily Dickinson, another poetry collection. And I've been meaning to read Dickinson for a long while now, so this is a perfect place to start, I guess. Then, before my holiday in England, we had this intern at work, and he was the sweetest. I was supposed to kind of train him in what I was doing at work. And after the 3 weeks, He ended up giving me a gift card to my favorite bookstore. And just a shout out to Burak if you're watching this. Thank you so much for the gift card. There was really no need to get me anything, but I really appreciate it. And these are the books I got with the gift card, so thank you so much again. The first book I bought with the gift card is The Forbidden Wish by Jessica Corey. This is a retelling of Aladdin, where the genie is a woman who falls in love with Aladdin. The second book I got with the gift card is A Tyranny of Petticoats, which is edited by Jessica Spotswood. This is a YA anthology of bells, bank robbers and other badass girls. And I've wanted this for so long and now I finally have it. I'm really excited to read this. And the final book that I ordered to my local bookshop finally came in a few days ago. And I'm really excited to read this one as well. And the book is Hot Dudes Reading. And this is a book that's based on the Instagram account, if you're not familiar with it, which is Hot Dudes Reading. What's not to love? Guys reading books, like, best thing ever. I think that's all the books I got from England and from Finland in June. So let me know in the comments down below if you have read any of these books and what did you think of them. And I hope you enjoyed this video and I will see you in my next one. Bye!